Hi, my name is Witten and welcome back to my next episode on Terraformacraft. Today we will first look a bit what I did before off camera. So I built the roof, like I said, going out to the side. I'm not sure if I like this because the building is not very tall and the roof is going up very much, and also it's going out a lot. Maybe it's just me and it just needs to grow on me, but for now that is done. And this is my blacksmith. So down is open, and upstairs I was experimenting with some bricks and some cobblestone and some wood. So that's what I have done off camera. Also, after last episode I went a bit crazy with my prospecting and I got this copper, a little bit more. This is a bismuthinite that I have got till now. It's my cassiterite and some sphalerite. So zinc, tin, bismuth and copper. So today we will smelt some of the copper, smelt some of the sphalerite and make bronze. Now bronze is an alloy and you will need a metallurgy table for that. How do we make that? It's very easy. Take some smooth stone, can be any stone, and you put it like you would put a chest piece in vanilla, and this makes one metallurgy table. Now I won't make this one because I made one beforehand, of course. Where did I put it? Here. So this is my table. If you right click it, you have got four slots in top and you take out your alloy from this space. Now this is my bloomery, so I will use this to make my to melt my ore. Now when you melt something you have to catch it in some container. The container is called a ceramic mold. And how do you make this? Also very simple. Let's take some coal. You just take clay that we have found before, put it in one U-shape and you get four clay molds. And then to bake them you can use a very slow fire pit, or you can use this forge. Oh, left some meat inside. Now let us put these clay molds inside, one coal, and fire it up. So as you can see, this will gain heat, this will start to bake. So the end result is this ceramic mold. I will use this to catch the liquid metal. Now let us go up, take the other chest, 16 pieces and 18 coal. This seems to be about the correct the correct amount. to smelt 16 ore. So let's take these and 18 charcoal. You will see it fills nicely till the top. You can walk on this, it does not burn you. It should, I think, but it's fine for me. So when we go down, you will see now ore and charcoal. Let us do the same for the cassiterite. Let's take 16 again. This is why I made two of these, to make it a little bit faster. Throw everything inside. I advise you to take out the correct amount of charcoal and throw it inside in one time, otherwise you may throw in too much or too few. So let us go down, check on this one, still going. This one just started, so let us wait a little bit. So to make some tools and so on, while I was working on the roof to make chisels and so on and a hammer, I made these before. Now these are very simple to make. This one is copper, this one is bronze. Just let's use the crafting bench. You have to put double ingots in an eye shape, and that makes your anvil. This one is still going, this one has finished. So do we have So throw it in, it will be filled. Continue to do this. This one is not full yet because it's a green bar, so let's put these in our placeholders. These are simple andesite anvils, just because the heat doesn't go out of these unshaped ingots. This one has finished yet, and you can see there is still some charcoal on side, that's why it's burning, but not much. Okay. No, let's leave that one inside. Now this is a little bit buggy because you can see that things are not removed from your inventory. Now, every alloy has its own amount that you have to put inside. So for bronze you have to put 3 copper inside and 1 tin. Instead of doing this with copper to make bronze, to make the same tier of metal, you can also use bismuthianite if you want. So instead of this golden looking, actually bronze colored anvil, you can make a green colored anvil, and you can make bronze tools on it and vice versa. So let's make our bronze. Very simple. Three copper, one tin. Make sure they are still liquid. Put them inside and take out your 4 bronze. Let's use the last one. Also, is remember to put them inside an anvil so that nothing cools down. So that's it really. Nothing much more to explain. always consult the wiki. That's the best tip I can give really. It's dark, so let's sleep. There is still something that I want to tell. This is a upside down stair. Now, at first I did this. As you can see, the cursor becomes this small cube because I have made these with a detailed block with a chisel. Later on, I found out that you can make upside down stairs. I was wondering how. Well, it's quite easy. So, let's go to this wall. Put it here. So, normally you would hit the side or the top and it would create a normal stair. To make an upside down stair, just hit the bottom of the block. There you go, very easy. Now, you can't do this when you have two the same block types above each other. So let's try again. Up, nothing happens. So that does not work. I just had a crazy idea. Now, you know that when you put cobblestone at a height, it will drop down in TFC. So let's change it. Put that as a placeholder. Up. Doesn't drop. Ta-da! We got an upside downstairs. Let's remove. Oh, that's cool. This is cool. This will give me some new building options. It's cool. So that's it for now, I think. Okay, I checked the time on the video and it seemed that I have still some time left, so I will explain the other part of this puzzle. So now we have got alloys and unshaped ingots. We want to make these into tools and armor and so on. So what do we need? It is a scribing table. Scribing table we can use to make plans. Plans to make pickaxes, armor pieces and so on. So how to make a scribing table? Very easy. You take one piece of vanilla paper. It's made with three sugarcane things, one feather and five planks this way. So that makes a scribing table. So I've made one before. Let's remove the chest here. Scribing table. So it's very similar in look as the normal workbench. Let's take some ink. So we make this, it's called a marking, they call it ink, from these ink sacks. Let's take our scribing table, put the paper inside. You can put more than one piece inside, so that makes it much easier. So for example, if we want to make a helmet, to the same pattern as with the leather napping. So this will make a helmet. This should make greaves, and I'm already out of ink. So this will make 16. So let's not do all of these. There we go. That's plenty. So we have got helmet, greaves. Let's make our chest piece. There we go. And now the boots. This way. So just below. So this we will use to make our armor. And how do you make a pickaxe? Very easy. There you go. Now I'm drawing this in the middle, but that does not matter. You can do it on top, whatever you want. This is the knife. So it's always the same pattern as the napping. Axe. The hammer. Now a sword is a little bit more difficult. So it's a diagonal line actually. And just fill in the sides. So you get a sword, but you can also make a mace. Now at the moment the damage that it causes is the same. Now a mace, I don't remember how to make it, so I won't try even. I guess it's something like this. Okay, good guess. So there is still a chisel to make, a hoe and so on, if I want, but I won't make this for now. Let's put these plans inside. So let's clean up. Okay. So that's it, I think. So next episode we will make our armor and maybe a spare sword. Our pick needs to be replaced also. Well, it seems that almost everything needs to be replaced, especially our chisel. Chisel is actually very expensive because just the durability is very low of it, I think. I hope that they will change that, because making these things costs a lot. Especially when you use blueprints, it is way too expensive. For example, I made these chairs, and these are just two solid blocks. Removed everything else, used a blueprint on both blocks, and duplicated here, and almost one of these just breaks one bronze hammer and one chisel, which is crazy. So that's it for now. If you like the video, please leave a like, subscribe, and tell your friends. See you later. Bye.